Hi everyone and welcome along. So today we're going to talk about water meters and those tricky little devices down the hole in the front path or in the garden. And they're a bit tricky, aren't they? But would it be nice to have one indoors where you could take a reading and see exactly what you're using without doing all that caper out there on the path? Now, to that end, I have one of these here. It's an indoor one, and I know it's not going to be as accurate as the one out in your path, but it will still give you a good idea of what you're using. And if you just used it on the feed pipe to the garden, for instance, to know how much water you was wasting out there feeding the plants, that have to be done in this dry spell, unfortunately. But to that end, there's another good use for this. Now, a few of you may remember I did a video a little while back where I had a burst under the floor. It was a small leak that gradually got worse, and I didn't realise until it had gotten quite bad and had been leaking quite a while. So to that end, I kind of got this massive bill from the good old water company. Great, isn't it? So I found the leak and done it. Now, I thought about this after. It's a shame that I couldn't get notified of these leaks. But without these leak detectors everywhere under the pipe of my void, which goes on for miles under the floor, it would cost me a fortune and be a right rigmarole to try and sort out. I thought what I needed to do was take a reading one night when everything's finished, we're not using any more water, and then first thing in the morning, without flushing any toilets overnight, leave it all in there, don't run a tap or anything, and then take another reading, and I would have known that the meter had moved and I've been using water, which would mean a leak somewhere. Now, sometimes not necessarily a leak, it could be a leak in the sense of the toilet system could be running water into a pan and it leaks a very slight small line of water and you don't often see it, and that would then show up. And obviously roof tank overflows where you don't notice it's running down the wall or something like this. So it kind of gives you an idea if you want to do that kind of check whether you've got a leak, especially if you can't get to anything, the pipe's buried under concrete or something like this, and you're worried about a leak. That's when I think this might come in, and the idea is to fit it above the stopcock on your incoming main. Now, not everyone's going to be able to fit them there. They are a bit awkward, so it may be this is not for you. Some have them in cupboards, like mine, and some have them coming up the wall, some in the garage. So there's areas of difficulty for fitting one that might be easy for you, very difficult for someone else. So why don't we use the outside stopcock? Well, we have got a meter down there, yes, out the front. Mine's on the path. Now, let me tell you an example of what happens with that. Well, you go out and lift the lid if you can. It's usually full of dirt and earth, and you're trying to get the lid up, and you finally get it up square. And then there's a round polythene, it could be polythene, I've seen some with polythene, but usually a bit of hard cardboard, it's like a plastic styrofoam round thing around this. It looks like a bit of foam. Anyway, you put your finger in two of the holes at the top and you pull it out. When you do that, you look down at the meter, you see it down there, there he is, right down there, but it's covered in dirt, earth and stuff like that that's fell in. So then you stick your hand down, yeah, and you start to clean the dials off with a bit of rag on the end of it and get it off. And so at that point, you feel something rather tickling up the side of your arm. What's that? And you pull your arm out and to see the biggest spider you've ever seen running up your arm. And you're kind of running around the street like this, trying to get it off. Or I am anyway, because I hate spiders. So, I don't particularly like lifting stopcock boxes and looking at these or putting my hand down there too much. But anyway, that doesn't happen all the time, but it's happened a few times and I hate spiders. Anyway, so nice if you could have one of these in the kitchen where or wherever your main is. Mine, I say, is under the kitchen sink. I'll have to pull a few things out to have a look at it because Jan stuffs everything in the way of the cupboard, so I'm going to have to kind of pull it out and see what the reading is, and then in the morning see if it's moved at all, and it'll get an idea where it's a leak. So the follow-on video to this one will be actually fitting it. I'm going to fit it under my sink unit and show you how easy it is. It comes with a couple of connectors like this that go on here and here. So it's fairly simple, and it's just mainly just a case of cutting a bit of copper pipe out really and just fitting this thing in. So a moderately easy job that I think would pay dividends if you're worried about water usage. And in this time of high energy bills, I know the water one hasn't reached the same high sky as gas electric, but I'm sure it's on its way. It's going to be affected and go up the same a bit as the others, just simply because it's a utility and the companies can do it if they want to put that price wherever they like. I'm in the southwest and I'm under the highest water charging authority in England. They are sky high prices down here, so that's why I got whacked with a massive bill when that leak was going on me, and I knew nothing about it until the bill arrived. Well, no, actually, the pipe blew off underneath, and I had no water in the kitchen sink. Completely came away. So, teach me to keep a good eye on it. But anyway, there we are. That's a little story. So it's up to you what you think about one of these meters and fitting it indoors. I think it's a good idea, and I'd say I'm going to fit this one in under the kitchen sink and do that as a job and put it up when I've done it. Okay, well, that's about it though. Just a little one on that. All my stuff, here we go. Usual place. Derek and Birdie Free. Thanks for watching, guys. Bye-bye.